I'm not a Methodist, so I don't know the exact words for the structure, but they went from the local congregations to kind of the regional associations. And they worked it all the way up until the National Methodist Church passed a resolution. And not long after they did that, Mount Olive Pickle agreed to this contract. There were folks in the labor movement that thought we would never see this kind of victory here in North Carolina. 8,000 workers covered under a union contract. And Flock realized that if they could win that, then they could win justice for other farm workers in North Carolina. So now they have a big campaign against R.J. Reynolds Tobacco, trying to get justice for the workers who picked tobacco for R.J. Reynolds. This campaign's been going on for about 3 years now, and they're continuing to do the same kind of strategies, trying to put pressure on the CEO, getting the religious community and the civil rights community involved. So that was a major victory in North Carolina. In 2008, we had two other significant victories. One is not kind of your traditional union organizing victory, but I mentioned to you that the State Employees Association of North Carolina became affiliated with the Service Employees International Union. That was really significant, and this happened in 2008. In one fell swoop, 55,000 folks became part of a union. Now, they were already part of an employees association, but it was a huge boost to the labor movement and to unions in the state that the State Employees Association voted to become affiliated with a national union. So that was a big victory. And perhaps for me, the sweetest victory that we've had recently was the victory at Smithfield Foods in Tar Heel, North Carolina, which happened at the end of 2008, that December. If you think Flock's campaign with Mount Olive was long, that was 6 years. The campaign to win justice for workers at Smithfield was 15 years long. Basically, from the time that plant opened, workers were trying to organize. Now, the facility at Tar Heel, North Carolina, how many of you heard about Smithfield Packing or that campaign? Know anything about it? That facility is the world's largest pork slaughterhouse. 32,000 hogs a day they slaughter. I think it's one every 17 seconds. If you can imagine how fast workers got to be moving on that production line. So workers had a lot of health and safety concerns there because of the line speeds. And they felt like they couldn't get their concerns addressed. And when they did get injured, they were afraid to complain because they saw other folks get fired. Now, the company would say they fired them for another reason, but it was interesting that it happened just after they got injured. And they would send injured workers to the company clinic, where workers didn't feel like their information was being held confidential, and they weren't getting the best treatment. They'd just get kind of bandaged up and sent back to work on the line. So they had a lot of concerns, and they started trying to organize from the get-go. In 1994 and in 1997, they had unions elections. Both times, the union was defeated. But both times, the company broke the law and intimidated and illegally harassed workers.